my first time in the ocean. I went into the water, and then by the time I came out, I was in a completely different place. So that experience kind of showed me how powerful the ocean is. My name is Emmanuel Alegria. I'm a third year here at Oregon State, and I'm a double major in biology and earth sciences. This is my fifth research cruise. This is the longest one I've been on, but I've been on four other ones just off the Oregon coast. We collect sediment samples with some pores so we can see what kind of compounds they have and the composition. So same for the water. So we collect the water and then we filter that. And from the sediment in the filter, we can see how much basically organic matter there is in the water column. With the chemicals that are coming in, feeding the phytoplankton, which are the plants, the microalgae, the plants of the ocean. And this microalgae will be food for the zooplankton, and the zooplankton are food for the fish. And it's the whole food web, right? So understanding where the chemicals are coming from or the nutrients are coming from, it's pretty important to understand the whole dynamic and to see which process is providing the most amount of nutrients, right? Working with Miguel Goni is really cool. I really see myself like being like him when I'm older. When I mess up, he will just try to guide me to how to do it properly instead of just pretty much just kicking me out. Or if he thinks that I should just really throw myself out and just step out of my comfort zone, he'll have me do that too. Since I started talking to Miguel and since I got the shore science and the URSA, I changed my major. So I'm changing basically my life goal. I really want to be a researcher. I mean, I wouldn't really care taking 10 or 15 more years, right? I just think if I get to be an oceanographer every day for the rest of my life, I feel like that would be worth it.